All right, today I'm gonna change my brake fluid. I've taken the cap off already, drained some of that out, but I did not drain it down to the point where air is gonna get into the system. Don't want that. I'm starting at the rear furthest wheel from the brake system. And I believe this is it here. It's the bleed valve. Yep. That's it right there. I bought a pump, MightyVac pump, from one of the automotive stores here. And as you can see, this is some of the brake fluid I took out of the master cylinder. Oh, it's pretty black. It should have been changed years ago, I'm sure. But this takes a two-person job and turns it into a one-person job. I did my wife's car like this yesterday. A lot of the fluid out of the master cylinder, which is here, it's not totally dry. I didn't want to take it completely dry because I don't want to introduce any air into the system. That's not good for brakes. So just take a bunch of it, a bunch of the fluid out, and we're going to replace it with some new. This is just Prestone brake fluid. .3, be sure and get .3 or .4 for the Honda. It's listed on the cap, but you don't want to put the wrong fluid in. So that's the fluid that came out of the master cylinder. I'm going to discard that. Then we're going to go to the, well, we're going to actually put some brake fluid in it to top it off, bring it back up. Then we're going to bleed the brakes, well, suck the fluid out until it goes clear for that wheel. Gonna start at the passenger rear, then the passenger driver side, then the passenger front wheel, then the driver's front wheel. So you want to go from the furthest wheel from the master cylinder to the closest.
I topped off the brake cylinder with fresh brake fluid. So we're gonna go back here. It's topped off. You don't want that cylinder to get dry. So it's a little bright. If you can see, I attached the nipple there. That's a 10 millimeter socket right here. Box end wrench, 10 millimeters. And it's just connected to this. And I've got it loose already, so, well, yeah. Just have to turn it. So, you can see fluid. And I'm just gonna pump this. Now, I read somewhere you don't really wanna go more than 15 pounds. And I'm just pumping it. There we go. And you can see it's slowly coming into here. So we just keep doing this until the liquid comes out clear. So we're going to keep doing that. But you want to keep an eye on the reservoir because it's already going down some. You don't want that to go dry. So just put it in. Just refill it occasionally so it won't go dry.
All right, gonna keep going.
All right, I've worked my way up to the front passenger side and I've pumped it in using my MightyVac. And as you can see, I've pumped it to where the fluid is clear now. So I've gotten all the impurities out. So, got one more tire to go, and that should be it. Mobil 1 oil filter, best filter on the planet. It's kind of expensive though. It's pretty good though. All right.